Hey guys, welcome to another math lesson by Magic Monk. Today we're going to talk about if you are given a graph of a quadratic equation, how would you find the equation of the graph? So let's draw a quick quadratic graph. Which is in the form of a parabola. So let's say this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. And I'm gonna give you the x-intercepts. So I'm gonna give you x-intercept of 2 and an x-intercept of 5. And I'm gonna say that the parabola passes through these two points. And I'm also going to give you one other point, and that is the y-intercept. I'm going to say it passes through the y-axis at 3. So how would you find the equation of this graph? Well, if you remember the factored form of quadratic formula of quadratic equations, where if we have y equals, for example, x minus a and x minus b, then the x-intercepts will occur at x equals a or b. Right, let's try that here. So let's try putting in the graph of y equals x minus 2 and x minus 5 into the Graphmatica and see what happens. Let me just clear the graph. So if I put in x minus 2 and x minus 5 into Graphmatica, it gives me a parabola, and the parabola does have x-intercepts at x equals 2 and x equals 5. So that's great, but is that the graph we want? No, it's not, because we want the line to cross the y-axis at y equals 3. So we know we're getting close, but that is not the equation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a coefficient at the front of this term, and I'm going to call it y equals a bracket. Actually, since we already used a before, actually it doesn't matter. So y equals a bracket x minus 2 x minus 5. And we want to find out what a is. By the way, this a has nothing to do with this a. It's just another variable I've made up. Actually, I'm going to call it another variable just so you don't get confused. I'm going to call it c. So what is c? Once we find out what C is, then hopefully we will end up with an equation that matches the graph. So let's now use the y-intercept that we're provided. So this point here says that when x is equal to 0, y is equal to 3. That is the y-intercept of this graph. So I'm going to put that coordinate into the equation. So 3 equals c bracket 0 minus 2 bracket 0 minus 5. So I've substituted this point into my equation, and that way I can find out what c is. So now I'm going to simplify the equation, c times negative 2 times negative 5, so that's 3 equals 10c, so c equals 3 over 10. So I'm now going to try typing this equation into Graphmatica. So y equals 3 over 10 x minus 2 x minus 5. And I'm going to see whether that is going to give me the same graph as the graph, the line that I've drawn here. So y equals, let me clear that. Y equals 3 over 10. Notice I'm putting 3 over 10 in brackets. X minus 2, x minus 5. And if you have a look at the parabola, this is exactly the same as what we were looking for. It passes through the y-axis at 3, and the x-intercept is at x equals 2 and x equals 5. So I'm going to give you another one and see if you can find it. So here it is, an equation, a graph where the x-intercepts, I'm going to say, are four and negative two, and it crosses the y-axis at negative one, just to see whether that is possible. Maybe it's not possible, I'm not sure. So have a go, see if you can find it. Pause the video, come back once you've had a go. Okay, so the equation is y equals c bracket x minus a bracket x minus b. So we know that a and b are negative 2 and 4, so c bracket x minus negative 2 and x minus 4. And here, obviously, we can rub it out and make it into a plus here, because minus and negative becomes a plus. Okay, so what we want to do now is find c. So when x equals 0, y equals negative 1. So negative 1 equals c bracket 0 plus 2 bracket 0 minus 4. So negative 1 equals c times 2 times negative 4. C equals, sorry, 2 times 4 is negative 8. Negative 1 equals c times negative 8. So c equals negative 1 divided by negative 8, which is just 1 over 8. So c is equal to 1 over 8. So putting that into our final equation, we should have this line as y equals 1 over 8 bracket x plus 2 bracket x minus 4. So let's try graphing this in Graphmatica. So I'm gonna get rid of my other equation. So I'm gonna type in y equals 1 over 8 x plus 2 x minus 4. And it has indeed given me a parabola where it touches the x-axis at negative 2 and 4, and touches the y-axis at negative 1. So that's awesome. So hopefully now you guys can find the equation of a parabola given the x-intercepts and one other point, in this case the y-intercept. See you next time.